Welcome everybody, I'm CJ Best, Director of Manufacturing here at McKinstry. We're going to take a tour of our brand new manufacturing facility located here in Spokane, Washington. In this space, we have our virtual design teams, as well as our shop management and our shop foreman. We have McKinstry branded graphics, we have a nice huddle space, conference room, a couple offices. It's a really great upgrade from where we were before and allows our virtual design teams to walk straight out to the shop floor. This is our break room. We're really excited about having this space. It's a great place for the crews to take a break and have a meal. It also doubles as a training center. This portion over here is our tool crib. This team manages all of the tools that support our job site operations, as well as other supply chain activities. Now we're going to head into the production space. One of the big features of this space is to be able to support our off-site construction efforts. We purposely programmed the building to have ample flex space to allow for modular construction. So you can see down in this bay, we have almost a third of the entire building is flexible space that can allow us to do multi-trade racks, pump skids, carrier skids, whatever the customers need. One of our key suppliers is located just across the street. You can kind of see it through the door there. So they will forklift the pipe over, set it right outside this concrete wall, and then we can load it directly onto our CNC machine, process everything, get it cut down to length, add the bevels, add any holes that need to go in the pipe, and then get it ready for the fit up and weld process. You'll notice one of the things that we programmed into this space is a lot of safe hoisting mechanisms. So a huge upgrade from our prior facility where we didn't have any overhead cranes. So up high, you'll see we have jib cranes to support work areas and work cells. And then we have bridge cranes up above when we need to hoist heavier items. We have four welding booths that support piping operations. We have the ability to flex up to six or seven as demand needs. This is our cast iron prep station. Material will come in, get loaded on this hydraulic table. They can elevate that to the same elevation as the load table. The workers don't have to lift it. They can just slide it along until it's been cut down to size. So we've got various racks for different material types. Back here we have storage of different fittings needed, and then our clean cutting process for med gas systems. It's a pretty neat design that McKinstry's internal team came up with. They've got a distance measure here, and then they can wheel this along. And there's a stop on that side. So depending on that, this will give them the readout of what that length is. So they don't actually have to pull a tape on it every single time. So pretty clever invention, originated out of our Seattle office about, I don't know, 10, 12 years ago. And then we've deployed that to our other facilities in the regions. So that's the plumbing shop. Materials all designed to flow in a circular fashion. We tried to reduce the amount of intersection points as much as possible. And so this is kind of the main thoroughfare. You have your work cells working in a circular fashion that feed into here, and then everything feeds towards the west side of the building to go out towards doors 2, 3, 4, or 5. Now we're making our way over to the sheet metal operation. Again, similar material flow. Material will come in on the east side of the building and work its way through, get processed, and then go out the west side. Based on the size and constraints of this facility, all the material that we process for sheet metal is flat stock rather than coils. The fiber laser allows us to cut whatever pattern we need into the metal, and that takes the kind of rollout pattern from the 3D model and goes through a computer-aided manufacturing process, goes through our inputters to ensure that all the parts and pieces are in the right spot and it's gonna work correctly downstream. And then they'll import that directly into the fiber laser to be able to be cut out. So material will be cut on the fiber laser, and then depending on if it's supporting round or rectangular ductwork, it will go through whichever product line. So ductwork will come through, get formed, they'll assemble it here in the assembly area, and then it'll get loaded onto carts to go out to the job site. We also have two welding booths to support our specialty welding needs, whether that's air handling unit curbs, stainless, or grease exhaust ductwork. We can support all of those needs here from Spokane rather than relying on one of our other facilities. For any iron work, we can cut our iron on our marble saw here, and then it can go get welded and then go out the door to the job site and wherever it needs to go. The last function we have here is our high purity team. So they do a lot of process piping work that supports pharmaceutical manufacturing. So here you'll see material that's been staged. It's all bundled and capped and kept very clean. It has to have tracking ability from the source of the material all the way through to installation. So we have a lot of paperwork and documentation that goes along with every single piece and every single fitting to make sure that we have chain of custody throughout the entire process. Here you can see we've got our receiving area, our clean fabrication space is in here. This space is positively pressurized, so it's pushing any particulates out of the space to make sure that no carbon dust or any other debris are getting into the space where we're actually performing the welding. So let's go take a look. So right now we're welding up utility panels for a pharmaceutical manufacturer here in Spokane, Washington. So all of this work has to be clean work, which is why it's done in our positive pressurized room. So they'll go through, we have the sheets that come from our detailing team that label and indicate everything that needs to go into this panel. And then we have our spool weld log that identifies all of the welds that were made on any single assembly and who made that weld to make sure we have that, again, that chain of custody throughout and understand who did what. So here we have welds that have been completed and are just waiting inspection. If you come in and take a look, you can see how clean of a weld it is. Once it gets kind of polished up, depending on the specifications of the job, you might not even really be able to tell that there was a weld made. Each welder has gone through a certification process for this weld procedure, similar to on carbon steel or stainless, but this is just, it's a different set of standards and a totally different welding process than welding carbon. So a couple other things to highlight on the external part of the building is we have these 30-foot canopies that run the entire length of the building, and this allows for kind of protected storage from the elements, so to speak, which is very helpful for staging material that's ready to go out to a job site or just loading trucks or other things like that. And then you'll also notice the adjacent lot that we have, which is we're currently using for additional laydown of tools, equipment, etc. And we have aspirations to be able to grow into that space and have additional capacity when we need to. So the ability to support manufacturing in-house rather than sourcing out to third parties gives us a couple of different advantages. One is 100% overseeing of quality, right? So we can ensure it's a quality product that's going out to the job site, or if changes need to be made, we can make those changes in the production environment before they go out. The second key piece is lead time. So a lot of these job schedules today are very condensed, and so our ability to turn product around very quickly gives us that kind of ability to deliver on what we've committed to the customer in terms of an accelerated delivery for the construction project. So that concludes the tour for today. I hope you guys enjoyed taking a sneak peek behind our latest manufacturing facility. Until next time, have a good day.